I want to know why they are doing it, because we know when they went out, Woolworths is a good example, and banned all that Australia Day merchandise, huge backlash. A lot of consumers stayed away. It would have hit their bottom line. It lost them. Brad Banducci, as we know, that their CEO. There's a big insto block, so a block of institutional investors that are the union super funds in these companies. They're pulling the chain of the board directors. I know that. We all know that. But it's not driving value for shareholders. It's driving customers away, and it's upsetting workers. I mean, there's a report not so long ago that workers in these companies are not supporting these DEI initiatives. So how do we get our companies back?
Very hard to get our companies back, but let me say, in particularly in relation to the voice, I think the companies lost their way. They no longer supported the Liberal Party and would no longer support conservative causes. That left them fairly isolated. They believed they could buy insurance. How do they buy insurance? By devoting all their activity and shareholders' funds to supporting the Labor Party and the Greens. So they gave tens of millions of dollars to The Voice to bring about a racist constitution. Qantas put these vote yes stickers on its planes. And we saw this great humbling of corporations bending to the Labor Party, believing that they were protected. Having so one-sidedly supported Labor, they thought they were safe. Mm. But of course, this was a very bad
strategy. But they weren't. Labor went after them with the IR.
Of course not. Because once you've buried your friends or your former friends and alienated conservative interests who turn around and start attacking you, Labor and the Greens know that you have no defence. No one will come to your aid, and hence the Greens can propose a new $500 billion a year tax on corporations to eliminate capitalism entirely in Australia. And who's going to fight back against that? Certainly not Labor, and Liberals are put to one side. So they've
Just
their own
just
death
quickly,
warrant.
I'm going to be out of time. I agree with you there. We're finally seeing them actually going out publicly and speaking against the government, the BCA and others. But so are you saying that this is set in stone? We can't turn this around, that our companies are going to become more and more woke?
No, it's a self-correcting mechanism. The ASX, through its policies, have essentially denied us shareholders control. So we now see that private equity is growing 12 times as fast as public equity, and public equity is largely disappearing around the world. The number of listed companies in the US has halved in recent years. They got larger, but the number has halved. And nearly all the growth in world business is in private equity, because public equity is so discriminated against by regulators in particular. So that's a self-fulfilling prophecy. And companies know they've done themselves so much harm through these woke policies, go woke, go broke, that they, I think they've learnt their lesson and will turn around and behave very differently in future.
I hope you're right, Professor Swan. Thank you.